Welcome back, guys. This is Klokriecher for another review on the LEGO Star Wars set, and today I'm doing a review on the Republic Striker Class Starfighter, which came out in 2012 with 3 minifigures and 376 pieces, set number 9497, recommended ages 8 to 14, and it costs $45 in the US and 50 euros in Germany, and I found mine reduced at Target when I was in the US in California. And the components are made in Denmark, Hungary, Mexico, and the Czech Republic. And by the way, we get no stickers with the set, so all the pieces we get there are printed. So that's very unique about the set. Don't see that very often on a Star Wars set these days. And this set is part of the Star Wars Old Republic, Star Wars The Old Republic video game. And now I will show you the back of the box. Alright, and here we have the, here's the back of the box, and we get some play features right there, as usual, and we get the fight scene there, is Satie Shan and Darth Margus from Zen 950, which I don't have yet. And yeah, pretty nice looking set, and now I'll show you the instruction of the set. Alright, so here we have the instruction of the set, and the instruction has ...68 pages, and we get the comic builder advertisement, and we get a comic right there. And get the other sets here. I only have the 9497. This is the set which I'm reviewing. I don't have the Desert Skiff 9496. Stacy Teen's Jedi Starfighter 9498. The Sith Fury Class Interceptor 9500. The Gungan Sub 9499. Jabba's Palace 9516. And the Malevolence 9515. But I'm trying to get those sets, and by the way, we get 3 number bags, and this set is a 39 stepper, and this is what you build in bag 1. Bag 2 builds the 2 wings here, and bag number 3 builds the rest of the set, of course, and this is what you build in bag number 3. And now I will show you the up close of the extra pieces. And this is the pile of extra pieces we get with the set. And here we have the first minifig, and this is the droid T701. And some of you may count him as a minifig, some of you probably don't, because this is a brick build minifig. So anyway, this is a very cool droid. We get the little V here on the back, we get the R2 unit legs there, and the nice printed tie right there on the front. Really love that piece, and I also love the top here, so that looks very amazing. And yeah, don't see that very often on these days on Star Wars sets, and this is this is how the droid falls off. Anyways, this is how the top comes. How you put the top on. You put this fake gold stud right there. And then you put those dish pieces right there. And yeah, very nice figure. And now let's move on to the next one. Alright, so here we have the next minifigure. This is the Republic Trooper, and it comes with a minigun, which is a brick build minigun, which I don't really like, because if you compare those to the miniguns from the custom markets like Brick Arms, then you will realize that there are much better miniguns out there, but still very and detail minigun here for sure. And that guy here comes with black hair. No helmet for some reason, but it's still a great figure. He comes with some back printing on his torso, and I will take off the minigun to show you the front torso a little bit better. And this is one of the problems here which I have with the miniguns. If you want to take the gun off, something will break off. But anyways, this is how the minigun looks like. So if you wanted to do your own minigun without buying the custom ones, then definitely should take a look there, and you can build this one with the pieces you already own. And here's a better look at the Republic Trooper. He comes with printed legs and nice printed torso, and it looks like he has a knife printed on there, so very awesome. And here's some scars right there and some beard details, and this is his face. No second face, just a one-sided face, but still a very nice figure. Again, a little bit disappointed that we don't get a helmet for him. Wish we got that, but if you get the battle pack from 2013, then you will get him for the Republic Troopers. And I recently got the Sith Troopers versus Republic Trooper battle pack, but I haven't built this one yet. But anyway, now let's move on to the last minifig. And here we have the last minifig, and this is Satir Shan. And she's a Jedi, of course, and probably the main reason why you are getting this set. And you are collecting this for the minifigs, of course. And she comes with the Agent Trace here, some nice lipstick printings here, and some hair printed on the torso. And she has some curls right there, and a nice belt. Very nice design here on the torso, and she comes with a double-sided lightsaber. We like that. Kind of reminds me of the double-sided lightsaber from Darth Maul. So that's awesome. And let's get that out of the way. She comes with some dark gray glass, and she has some back printing, of course, and I will show you that right now. And here's the second face and the second torso. And she looked kind of angry there. And we get more hair details right there, some more belt details. It's a little bit odd looking because there's no printing here on the side of the torso. So it looks like a gap right there, and that's what's a little bit disturbing there on this figure. Don't really like that. I think Lego should do some more side printing on torso and arms. Awesome minifig. I think that would make them a little bit more unique. And yeah, very awesome figure. And now let's move on to the up close of the set. And here's the up close view of the Republic Striker class Starfighter. And one thing which I want to point out is that the Republic Trooper doesn't stay up on with the minigun. And yeah, he falls a little bit too easy there. So you have to maneuver in this position here if you want to stand him up better. But anyway, now let's get onto the ship. Again, no stickers with this set. So we get printed pieces. Those two pieces here are printed on, which is awesome. I also love the colors here with the dark red, the red, the white, and the orange. It looks really amazing. And those pieces here on the front can be adjusted. And you get this piece here. Kind of looks like a beak, so kind of looks like a bird if you want to. If you will. And here you get the lights there and there, and you get the cockpit right there, which you can open up. and there's a lot of room for the figure to sit in, and we get the nice printed controls there and the joystick, and I will get Satish Chan out of the cockpit for a while, and this is the inside. So that's awesome. And here's the back. We get the engines here with the translucent pink dish pieces here. So that's a nice touch there. And this is the way how you hide the double-sided lightsaber. You have to take it apart and put it on like this. It's okay. You don't have to put it there. But also want to mention that it doesn't really make a whole lot of sense to put those lightsabers in like this. I wish we had a better place for the lightsabers to put in, but it's all we got, and I'm happy with that feature. And this is the bottom. You get the kind of landing gears that you can't really adjust. And yeah, here we get the big laser cannons, and these are the flick missiles, and I will show you this feature in a minute. And this is how the Starfighter looks in flight mode, and of course the landing mode. And now I will move that, I will convert this spaceship into attack mode, and I will do it right now. Alright, now it's time for the spaceship to go in attack mode, and I will do it right now. But first of all, I want to show you the two pieces here, which allows you to do this feature, and you have to take the wings off like this, and you can see this handle right there, which goes on like right there, and you can see this piece which will go on like this, and then you have to maneuver the cannon, and can do the same thing on the other side, and there you go. Now you are in attack mode and you are ready to go. And this is how the flick missile launcher works, and you can see those technic pieces, and you have to push these, and then you will launch the flick missiles, and boom! There goes the flick missile. Like that one much better than flicking those missiles by hand. I think this mechanism is a little bit better. I've seen better flick missile features for some other sets which I don't have, like the extreme C-pop battle from the Iron Man 3 sets. That feature looks very amazing. Really likes the way how Lego designs that. But anyway, that's basically it for the up close of the set. I will show you some more details right there, and I will now move it back into the normal flight mode and the landing mode, of course. So here you have it, and now I will do the final thoughts and ratings about the set. Alright, so you have seen the close-up of the Republic Striker Cloud Starfighter, and overall I really love this set. We get some very nice minifigs, and I love the way that we get some printed pieces instead of stickers, and we don't see that very often on Star Wars sets these days. And I also love the color with the dark red, the red, the orange, the white. I think this is a very nice color combination, and I also like the way how the wings fold up and how you can convert the spaceship into attack mode, and I love that one as well. I also love the minifig. I think Satish Chan is the best minifigure of the set, and I think lots of you probably get this set because of Satish Chan. And yeah, really love this set. One thing which I don't really like is that we don't get an extra helmet for the Republic Trooper. I wish we got a helmet there, and I also think that there could have been a better place to hide the lightsabers. This is the place where you normally hide the lightsabers, this is set, but I've seen better variations there. But still a very awesome set, and I'm definitely going 9.8 out of 10. Would have given the set a 10 out of 10 if it came with a Republic Trooper helmet, but everything else is perfect. Really love the set. I highly recommend you to get this one. You should have the chance to get this one. Again, I found this one at Target when I was in the US. I found it reduced for a very awesome deal. And yeah, I definitely recommend you to get this one. So yeah, that ends up my review on the Republic Strike Class Starfighter. So please like, comment and subscribe. Don't forget to check out my playlist for all the other LEGO Star Wars reviews I've uploaded there. And also don't forget to check out my website for the gallery of the set I've uploaded there. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next time. Peace.